Okay, cool. Hi, everybody. I'm Mark.
Hi, Mark.
Hi there. So I can see, how many people are in there?
It's about like 17 of us.
Okay.
It's right about 30 right now.
Really?
Yeah.
He's counting.
Okay. I think I can't see everybody, but I can see almost everybody. Wait, where are you guys located?
Wichita, Kansas.
Oh, wow, cool.
We're in Bel Air right now.
Never been there. So do you want, I see a question there. You want me to just start by answering that? Or do you want to ask me a question to start? Or what? How do you want to do it?
However you want to start, you can go through the dialogue, or you can go through what you like to tell them. And then if there's anything really pertinent or pressing, you can comment on from there, or you can just keep your flow and keep the questions to the end. It's your choice.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll probably go off the questions. I like to be more interactive because I don't know, if you guys don't know about my work, I'll give you a little bit of a introduction to, I just finished making The Little Prince, which is available on Netflix, and that was a really incredibly difficult project, both creatively and from a production standpoint, because we used different animation techniques to tell the story. Before that, I did Kung Fu Panda. I was on the first Kung Fu Panda as one of the directors. And I did some short films, and that's where I really fell in love with making animation. And I've said this before, that if I could do anything, I would do short films, and I really do love it as a format, and I'm really excited for you guys. I think it's the best way to find out who you are as a filmmaker. It's the best way to find your voice. It's the best way to explore and be experimental. And I always tell people, try to tell a great story, tell a personal story, and that's like the most important thing you can do. And you know, that just gets harder and harder to do when you start working for other people, or you start sort of having to find a job, and you guys are lucky because you can actually just explore who you are as artists right now, and I really, really encourage that. One piece of advice I'll give you, I don't know if you guys, I wore this kind of accidentally, but I guess it's probably on purpose. This is like, have you ever heard of Everything is a Remix? Okay, so go look up Everything is a Remix. It's actually a great series of videos that it kind of crystallized a lot of ideas that I had and a lot of thoughts I had about filmmaking. We're really influenced by all the everything that we see. And the guy who made these videos, his name's Kirby, and he really went really in-depth about sort of how all art, everything that's being made today is influenced by everything that we've all sort of seen in the past. And I was hugely influenced by Star Wars growing up. And when I discovered that Star Wars was hugely influenced by the Joseph Campbell hero's journey and, you know, all these really core ideas about what it means to be a human and what it means to tell stories, I fell in love with the idea of telling stories and making movies as a way to communicate and how vital it is that we do that. So anyway, that's a plug. Everything's a Remix. It's just a really great series that made me a lot more comfortable about my process. I found myself really, really influenced by the things that I really was inspired by. And I always felt like I was ripping things off, and I always was worried that I was sort of like borrowing too much. And when I watched these videos, it was just like a great celebration of the idea that it's impossible to create artwork in a vacuum. You know, you're really influenced by, and I think you should dive into the things that you are, that you love, and analyze them and try to, you know, take inspiration as much as you can. So, all right, that's my plug. Okay, so what's the favorite part of my job? Favorite part of my job is working with other artists. I am really, really lucky in that I get to sort of collect groups of artists that are in love with telling the story that I want to tell. And especially on The Little Prince, I was looking for artists who love the material, who love the book. How many people have read The Little Prince? Not many. Really? You guys can hear me?
It was one of my favorites growing up.
Yeah, you know, it's actually a book I didn't read until college, so, you know, it's not, there's no harm in not having encountered it yet, but it's certainly a great book that taught me a lot about being an artist. So I highly recommend it if you haven't read it. But the great thing about that book is a lot of artists love that book, and so when I was gearing up to make The Little Prince into a movie, I really had an incredible ability to draw great talent across the board. So I was really, really happy and excited to be able to work with great artists. And, you know, it's just that's my favorite part, the collaborative nature of making films. I always say you can't do it by yourself. You actually, you know, of course you can, but I find it to be a far more exciting process and a more rewarding process to collaborate with other artists. And I always tell students, like, the sooner you guys can work together and help each other, the stronger you'll be and the better off you'll be, because it really is an important part. Being able to communicate what you want to do and being able to help give somebody help realizing their vision, it's a great way to help develop your skills as an artist, but also as a collaborator. It's really, 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 really important to be able to work with others. So that's my favorite part. What's it like to be a director for big movies? It's really hard. It's really rewarding. There's a lot of amazing aspects. I think being able to work with top talent is really the best. They'll be more profitable in the long run. So it really is a balance between the art and the business. So you have to have ideas that are marketable. You can't pitch ideas that just aren't marketable. You can't pitch an idea about, you know, demons who eat eyeballs and who, you know, like massacre babies and, but everyone's gonna love it. You know, nobody's gonna put money into something like that. Okay. When you say you like to make your short films really emotional, do you have in mind how you want the viewer to feel? Okay, the biggest thing that took me a while to learn is every single moment in your film, you should be deciding what you want your audience to feel. That is your job as a director. What do you want your audience to be feeling in every moment? And the sooner you can figure out what it is that you want your audience feeling in a moment, the easier it is for everybody you're working with to be able to give that to you. And it's the same thing. You want to know the result you're looking for, but you want to find that organic way to get there. Okay. Do you plan on exploring virtual reality? Maybe. I don't know how to tell a story yet in virtual reality, but I would be interested to try it. Have I seen Tangerine, the film that was shot on an iPhone? Was there something that technique was able to do well? I haven't seen it, but I love the idea of somebody making a feature film using an iPhone. That's really cool, and that makes me feel like an old man. Okay, crashed again. I think we're getting there. How do you put yourself in a movie that isn't truly yours? Like it's something out of the norm for you. Well, you have to connect to the material in some way. You have to find a way to connect. And that's one of the hardest jobs, I think, as a director. It's like that, you're not gonna be able to do your job effectively, and you're not gonna be able to get people excited about the movie unless you care about it, unless you can find a way to make it your own. So I have to say, if I can't connect to the material, I can't agree to the project. How old was I when I started creating movies and films? I was my brother and I used to goof around a lot. We used to do puppet shows, you know, and so I think it kind of goes back to when we were little kids. But it wasn't until high school that I started like filming with friends of mine. We started like making little skits and stuff. And I was really inspired by Saturday Night Live. I watched a ton of Saturday Night Live, and I, you know, so in addition to film. What's the maximum time a short film should be? As short as you can make it. If your film is 2 or 3 minutes and it tells a good story, you are going to be programmed in every film festival in the whole wide world. If your short film is 40 minutes, good luck. It has to be amazing to get people to stick around for 40 minutes. So do yourself a favor, try to be short. Video games as a medium. Not all are shooters or puzzles. Some give a story and just takes the player with it. Honestly, I'm a gamer, I love video games, but I hate it when a video game tries to be a movie. So I think video games are video games, movies are movies. How do you get actors to convey the right emotion? Here's the best advice I can give you on directing actors. Don't tell them what you want the result to be. Allow them to create their own result, okay? If you know you want the feeling of the actor being sad, don't say do it sad. Say give them a direction that will allow them to find their own way to their personal version of sadness, okay? Because you want that to be honest. So what I might say is, you know, wow, your kid just slammed the door in your face, you know? Or I might give them an image, I might give them an idea, or I might say, plead with somebody, beg with somebody, you know, give them a verb, give them something to do that will ultimately give you the reaction you want. Okay, I love you guys.
Hey, we love you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, I love you.
We love you.